हाय सर, आई एम मेघा फ्रॉम वेस्ट बंगाल। मुझे बहुत ही खुशी हो रहा है क्योंकि मेरा एक ड्रीम था आपसे मिलने के लिए, आज वो हो रहा है, इसीलिए मैं बहुत ही खुश हूँ सर। थैंक यू सो मच सर।
Thank you. It's a pleasure to meet you, and I'm really excited. Wonderful, your spirit and your love for chess, and well, we'll get to see a little bit of it today.
आप जब छोटे थे तब से आप चेस खेल रहे हैं, तो आप चेस में इंटरेस्ट कैसे मिला आपको?
So when I was six, my brother and sister were playing chess casually. They were not very serious about the game, but you know, the youngest one always wants to do whatever the others are doing. So I immediately went to my mother and said, "You have to teach me how to play chess, and I want to sit there and pretend that I belong." So my mother taught me at the age of six. Within a few months, they realized, "Oh, you know, he's not lost interest yet." And so the next thing was to put me in a chess club. So Megha, how did you come into contact with chess, and how did you start?
मैं हॉस्टल में रहती थी। एक्चुअली हॉस्टल पे एक सर आते थे, सर के पास गए और सर को बोला मैंने, सर मुझे चेस सिखाइए ना, मुझे सीखना है। तब मैं 2 स्टैंडर्ड में थे, वो ईयर के लास्ट में मैंने एक टूर्नामेंट गए थे खेलने के लिए, ब्लाइंड टूर्नामेंट। तो उधर जाके मैंने बेस्ट वोमेन को प्राइज मिला था मुझे, फिर उधर से मेरा चेस शुरुआत हुई।
You want to know what happened in my first tournament? I lost my first three games, and anyway, I went for the fourth game, and I got my first point because I got a walkover. My opponent didn't come that day, and afterwards, I got a chess book from the organizers on the last day in the prize ceremony. I mean, probably they were amazed that I even went to the prize ceremony because I wasn't winning anything. So they had a book for me which said for perseverance. So that was my first prize in chess.
एक टफ पोजीशन में आप जब खेलते हैं तब आपको कैसा फील होता है?
Quite often, I can smell that something is wrong before it happens. So by the time I get into a bad position, I have already changed my frame of mind. You know that then you immediately look, what did I do wrong? Why am I feeling like this? And it hits. But it's not a nice feeling. It never is. How do you experience it?
तो जब प्रेशर आता है मैं शांत से बैठती हूँ, 2-3 मिनट ब्रीदिंग करती हूँ। एक गेम का मेरा याद है सर, मैंने वो बहुत मतलब मैंने मेरा वो पोजीशन पूरा गए थे मेरे हाथ से। उधर से मैंने बहुत टाइम से सोच के और अच्छा से खेल के उधर उसने एक मिस्टेक कर दिया था, इसीलिए मैंने वो गेम निकाला था। मैं आपको रिक्वेस्ट कर रही हूँ कि आप मेरे साथ एक गेम खेलेंगे।
Of course, it's a pleasure for me to play with you. I think we can do 15 plus 10. Is that okay?
Okay, okay, sir. Okay.
You were playing extremely well, you developed well, all that. You lost a lot of time with your queen.
Yes.
But then a couple of moves were duplicating each other because if the opponent is having a plan and they're executing it and you're just going back and forth, that's not helpful. But it's very good what you're doing. You're checking your game immediately afterwards. You know what happens to me? If immediately after I play a game, I go home and I try to remember what I did.
Okay.
What happens is very often I will only remember what I wish I did. I will not remember what actually happened. So how you should do is you should go home, try to reconstruct the variation without any help.
Okay.
And write down, okay, this is what I think I was going to do at the board, and then check with the computer. And this is quite funny, but if you then check into the computer, but you've already written down what you were going to do. So if the computer says you were wrong, you will not adjust your memory. You will simply remember what is what you were going to do. But this is very healthy, because if you try to think and remember what you, just like you did in the game, and then you check if it was correct or wrong, then next time you know what can go wrong. So this is a very good way to grow.
Thank you, sir, for suggesting me.
Also, did you see this in the game, that you went queen d2 and I went...
Sir, please tell me move number.
Yeah, it's move 17. You went queen d2, right?
Yes, sir. Queen d2.
Okay. You don't need this move at all. Because
queen d2, I think I put bishop on f4.
No, but this is... I briefly forgot that as well. But if I go rook d6, you cannot play bishop f4. Do you see why?
Oh.
I'll give you one clue. You did something on move 13, and that allows me something now. Can you see what you did on move 13? Okay, I won't torture you much more. With that clue, you just think
knight,
about...
Knight takes c3.
Your king is on c1, your bishop is on f4.
I did not see, sir. Bishop?
h6.
Okay, bishop h... Yes, I missed my... Sir, main aapse ye puchna chahti hu, aap chess se matlab kya kya sikhe hai?
Probably the most important thing is to be careful before you make a move, because you can't take it back. So this, in chess it's basically just the rules, but at the same time it's almost a philosophy. You need to be very careful about your decisions before you make them. The second thing is to always focus on the position in front of you. It doesn't matter how many chances you missed before or how lucky you were before. The only thing that matters is what's in front of you right now. I would say this is almost philosophical. Both these attitudes, if you can learn from chess, then they work perfectly well in life as well. Besides that, I think in chess, it's very important not to have very strong opinions on what is right and wrong. You must be willing to learn. If the evidence changes and new conclusions are coming, then you should be able to adapt and try new things. And only if you keep doing that, your chess will be up to date. That's maybe one more thing. What else? Don't be disheartened by defeat, and don't give yourself too much credit for success. And don't relax till you achieve your goal. Megha, what do you feel chess has taught you? What do you do differently because of what you've learned in chess?
Sir, first, मुझे लगता है कि मैं एक partially blind player हूँ. तो मुझे ये लगता है कि ब्लाइंड लोगों के साथ खेलने के लिए और साइटेड लोगों के साथ खेलने के लिए अलग कुछ नहीं होता. सिर्फ हम खेलते हैं अच्छा से. और दूसरी होता है सर, चेस ने मुझे ऐसा सिखाया क्या जो काम मैंने पहले नहीं कर पा रही थी. मतलब मुझे लगता था मैं ब्लाइंड हूँ, मैं कैसे कर पाऊँगी. तो ये चेस मुझे आत्मविश्वास जगाया क्या नहीं तुम कर पाओगे. और दूसरी चेस सर मन से खेला जाता है. तीसरी क्योंकि वो मन और ब्रेन एक रहेगा कि हमको खेलना है, हम आगे जाके कुछ कर पाएंगे और खेलना है, ये सोच के अगर हम खेलेंगे तो हम ब्लाइंड है क्या साइटेड है इसमें कुछ फर्क नहीं करता है चेस. और ये जो गेम है वो सबके साथ ही खेला जाता है सर. तो ये मुझे अच्छा लगता है खेलने के लिए और ये मैंने सीखा है चेस से.
Wonderful. Actually, it's a great lesson, point you made, which is that it's wonderful that you are able to access your full potential in chess. In fact, the ability to visualize the board without making the moves is what makes you a stronger player. And I think it's wonderful how you've managed that.
Thank you, sir.
How often do you practice in a day or in a week? How often do you play and practice?
4 hours, 5 hours.
you should remember to keep time to relax, to get away from the game also, and then you come back and play better. In 2020, I have also struggled to adapt to all the changes. First of all, because it was a non-negotiable thing. I mean, the pandemic came and we've had to adapt. Feels almost like a gunpoint. And one of the things I've come to appreciate is that this is the long haul. So, you know, if you have to be disciplined and do this for a week or do some extreme effort for a week, that's okay. But this is the long haul. My experience tells me it's a good chance to try new things and learn new things, because we won't have this kind of time, hopefully, in the future.
So, sir, आप मतलब जो सुन रहे हम लोगों को आज जो देख रहे हैं ये तो आपको आपका सजेशन क्या है उन लोगों के लिए आप क्या बोलना चाहेंगे?
Well, what I'm going to do as well is just keep practicing, keep trying new things, and the same for you. Just practice. Play once in a while, and if you keep trying new things, then you will become stronger. It just happens. Even if you don't see progress for a while, it will suddenly one day you'll realize that you're seeing everything much better.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
I'm very happy and proud to be with you all in the India Inclusion Summit 2020. I have had the chance to interact with many people who find that chess is a great outlet, and it's a game that even people with disabilities are able to play at a very high level. I essentially think that society has to just take into consideration the special needs of people. It's mostly thoughtlessness which we need to fight against. I'm very supportive of any initiative to make India more inclusive, and it was a pleasure playing chess with Mega today.